Right, okay, in this video I'm going to show you one of these ball labyrinths connected to an iPhone. This is pretty cool because I can tilt the iPhone and play the game as if I was moving the control knobs here and here. I'm going to give you a brief overview of how this works. I'm using the serial servo board from botbuilder.co.uk. And this little board I've covered in my other videos. Basically you can put serial into it, out to 12 servos with 3 digital I.O. so you can switch things on and off. You can also record any sequences and play them back without you having the host computer connected, which is quite cool. Okay, so I haven't got these back from the factory yet, so we're using the messy dev board, but it works in exactly the same way. Okay, so if I grab this, you can see as I move it, it's moving the platform, and it also shows here on the screen the orientation of the iPhone, or in this case an iPod touch. Okay, this is done through processing. There's a bit of code here, you can just about see it. It's literally only a few lines. There you go. Okay, the way it works is the iPhone or iPod is running touch OSC, which talks over Wi-Fi to processing, which in turn talks over serial, this wire here, into the board, and the board is talking to the servos. Now what I've done is the existing control knobs here, I've mounted a servo horn to a servo. So there's one there and there's one there. You see them turning away. Right, and as cool as this is, it's actually almost impossible to play. Either that or I'm extremely crap at it. So I'll give you a demonstration. Now I've got to try and do this with one hand holding the camera. Okay, let's try and get them both into shot. See what I mean? Number one, how bad am I? I think I've made it down to 6. There we go. I think it's just hard for me to do holding the camera as well. Hey, number 4. It is quite responsive. He says, it is quite responsive. It all depends on the speed of the computer. I found out. I tried running this using my little netbook, and it was spluttering all over the place. But I'm on a dual core system here, and it seems to be fine. Oh dear. I think I'll give anyone a tenner who can do this. There we go. Oh. Well, you get the idea. An iPhone controlled labyrinth.